We continue our working day at Ukraine Crisis Media Center. And now the floor is given to Colonel Alexander Matuzianik, Ministry of Defense of Ukraine spokesperson on NATO-related issues. Welcome. Good afternoon, everyone. Now, information about the main events that happened yesterday in the anti-terror operation zone. Our today's briefing will start with the good news. Yesterday, during the last 24 hours at the front line, no Ukrainian serviceman was killed or wounded. The Lugansk sector, yesterday, militants violated ceasefire three times. In the evening, at twilight, the occupants opened fire with the use of grenade launchers and small arms in Krymskaya, Lobochevo, and Stanitsa Luganska. Enemy provocations were carried out up to half hour each. The Donetsk sector near Avdiivka, there is active armored confrontation, and before dawn, the enemy used tanks and mortars in the region of the town. The occupants were active in the south, Spartak, and the east, Yasinuvata. And the occupants delivered fire at fake position of armed forces and later at real Ukrainian position. Ukrainian servicemen took decision to return fire, and this allowed to stop the activity of the enemy. And one more enemy shelling was near Avdiivka industrial zone after sunset. And from 10 to 11 p.m., the enemy delivered fire with the use of small arms. And during afternoon, the enemy delivered fire in the region of Kamianka. And the situation was tense in the region of the Donetsk airport. Also, our Pisky and Niversk positions are also under attack. And flash spots are near Pisky, where the shellings were the longest. And near occupied Gorlovka and in Svetlodarsk Bulge, it was calm yesterday. On the whole, during the last 24 hours in the Donetsk sector, there were seven enemy shellings, including three with the use of heavy weapons. The Mariupol sector, the places of ceasefire violations are traditional in Mariinsky region and in the south of the direction, and also in Marienka. In the morning, the militants delivered armored provocation with the use of small arms. In the south of the Mariupol sector, enemy shellings happened on Gnutova, Talakivka, and Shirokina. And one of them in Talakivka, the militants used mortars in shelling. And during the last 24 hours in the Mariupol sector, they recorded five enemy shellings. Yesterday, they continued to liquidate the consequences of fire in the military warehouses in Vinnytsia. Situation is under control. Sapers carry out examination of the warehouses, adjacent regions and settlements. Residents of military base and neighboring villages started to return home. Avdiivka law enforcers revealed more than 1,000 cartridges. And the man this year found a cart with ammunition in the territory of the town and decided to hide it in an abandoned construction site. At the place, law enforcers found a metal cart with 1,080 cartridges to Kalashnikov gun. Law enforcers confiscated ammunition and sent it for examination. And in Alexandria, in Kirovograchino, they complete training for paratroopers of the National Guard. The topic of the training is airdrop, emergency landing and parachuting. Servicemen carry out parachuting with the use of systems of different modifications. They do it during the day and at night. They are parachuted on land and on water. And also, there are exercises for evacuation of wounded with the use of adapter M1 system. At the same time, in the Nechina court released from criminal responsibility one more participant of SBU program that is called They Wait For You Back Home. Law enforcers identified that in 2015, the resident of Donetsk Oblast, under the influence of propaganda of Russian will, joined the DPR militant group. And he served the checkpoints, and also he controlled so-called public order in the occupied territories. He saw looting and chaos and lawlessness that was done by pseudo formations, and the man got disillusioned and left the ranks of Russian occupation forces. Now he is at home with his family. Former militant is sure that he made correct decision, and he called on others to follow his lead. And lastly, in Zhytomyrsk Military Institute named Actor Sergei Korolev, they continue field exercise. The students shared with experience of ATO operation in the firing ground. They do such exercises as ambush, counter ambush, repel of sudden attack of the enemy, battle in the forest, and overcoming ruined and mined sites on the road. Thank you.